Yo, what's going on YouTube? It's Ludin Kuma again, back with another guide. Today we're going to talk about when and why to 3-star units in TFT. Let me start out by saying, I'm not talking about hyper-rolling. I'm talking in a very generalistic way, a way you can play game to game when you don't have a specific plan in mind, and you can have consistent, reliable success. I will be releasing a everything you need to know about hyper-rolling guide in the future, including how you manage your money, what comps typically run the hyperroll strategy, and more. So if you're interested in that, go ahead and hit subscribe, but let's tackle the general topic first. As a crude overgeneralization, typically getting a champion to 3-star is not worth the risk or the money unless your entire composition is based around that one single unit. If every other champion in the comp is in there to stack that one unit might be worth 3-starring. But I want to do this topic justice. I want to talk about the 5 pools of champions based on cost. So let's dive into tier 1 champions. Tier 1 units are the most forgiving units in set 2 to go for 3 stars because they're just so cheap. You can hold on to them on your bench and it won't cost you a ton of money. But even still, with them being so cheap, I rarely 3-star tier 1 units. The times that I do 3-star units is when I am healthy and ahead of the lobby. If by stage 3, I have plenty of gold and I have HP lead and I'm rolling a lot of one champion, I'll go ahead and go for it if no one else is going to 3-star that unit as well. If I see someone else is going to 3-star that unit, I'll just ditch it. I would rather convert that extra gold that I would be spending to hold on to those units on my bench into a lead with my economy or a lead with my experience inside the game. So let me give you an example. Let's say I'm playing Ocean Mage and I've rolled 5 Vladimirs by stage 3-2. I take a look around, there's one other person playing Mage, but he's not going for 3-star Vladimir. I might as well go for it. It's not gonna cost me a ton of gold, especially if I'm doing fine in the game, I might as well go for it. But let's say I've rolled 5 Vladimirs and there's 3 other Ocean Mage players. Even if none of them are going for 3-star Vladimir, I'm not going for it anymore. There's too many Vladimirs pulled out of the pool. It's gonna take me too long to find that 3-star Vladimir for what it's worth. By the time I hit it, it's probably gonna be stage 5, and Vladimir is almost a non-factor by stage 5, and a lot of comps you're switching out of Vladimir anyways for a stronger unit in the late game. So I probably just ditch it in that scenario. Alright, so now let's talk about tier 2 units. Tier 2 units are very rare to 3-star because most of the tier 2 units just aren't that advantageous to 3-star. Unlike set 1, a lot of the tier 2 units in set 2 are just not that powerful. So getting them to 3 stars typically doesn't secure you a victory, and oftentimes is going to cost you a lot of gold. Let's look at Malzahar. Malzahar is a unit that in a shadow comp isn't a bad idea to get to 3 stars. It takes 6 gold to get Malzahar from level 1 to 2. You're then going to be investing another 12 gold into Malzahar, and you're investing bench space just to get him to level 3. At level 3, he's getting a minor damage increase, and you're getting another Voidling, yes, but by the end of the game, these Voidlings are getting AoE'd down pretty fast, and oftentimes it just isn't worth it. I would say the only time you would go for a 3-star tier 2 unit is when you're stable and you've rolled over 4 of them by stage 3-2. You've hit every other unit that you needed to hit by that point in the game. Every other unit is 2 stars, you're super healthy, and you have a lot of gold to play around with. Alright, so now let's talk about tier 3 units. Tier 3 units are actually kinda common to 3-star.
Similar to how hyper-rolling bases your comp around 3-starring 1 cost units, there are a lot of comps going around right now that are based around 3-starring tier 3 units. These comps include anything between Vhagar carry inside of an Ocean Mage comp, forgoing the brand, or Sivir carry inside of a Blademaster comp. Basically, unless your entire comp is structured around that one champion, you probably don't want to 3-star it.
These units have the potential to carry you really hard in the mid game, so getting them to 2-star is your mid game secured. And instead of going into 4 or 5 cost units later on, you can actually just pick up more of those units. Let's take Sivir, for example. You can get Sivir to rank 3, and she can be your late game carry. There's a lot of tier 3 units in the game right now that are super strong and scale really well if you get them to 3 stars and you have the right items on them. If no one else is playing around that carry, feel free to try and get the 3 star if you're in a position to do it. I would say if by stage 4-1 you've rolled at least 4 of them, consider it. Now again, 3 starring any unit is a little bit on the risky side, but tier 3s are a really good bet. I would say tier 3 units have the most likely chance to have an impact in the game and are the most likely to get 3 starred, making them the happy medium to try and 3 star within a game and making that tier 3 unit your win condition. Alright, so let's talk about tier 4 units. You're almost never gonna 3 star a tier 4 unit. I'd say the only time you're getting a tier 4 unit to 3 stars is when you're absurdly rich, insanely ahead, you're into stage 5, the rest of your comp is already come together, and you're tapped. So I'll give you an example. Let's go back to Ocean Mage. You're playing Ocean Mage, you have every unit you need, you've already hit your Nami, you've already hit your frontline, all of your other mages are in place, it's stage 5-1, you're rolling down and you found 2 other brands. You're in a healthy position, you're already tapped for power, you're not going to get any stronger. You can try and 3-star it, especially if no one else is playing Ocean Mage. If anyone else is playing that tier 4 unit, you're almost never going to 3-star it. And lastly, tier 5 units. Basically never. I've only seen one in my entire time of playing TFT. Now let's say you've rolled 3 Amumus, you have your tier 2 Amumu, and you're seeing more Amumus come in, and you're level 9, and you have extra bench space, you can play 2 tier 2 Amumus. But don't forego building the rest of your comp to try and 3-star this tier 5 unit. It is so unlikely that it's going to happen.
And I think that sums it up. If I miss anything, make sure you leave a comment down below. I respond to every single comment in all of my videos. If you have any questions pertaining to anything else TFT, make sure to check me out on my live stream on twitch.tv/Luden_Kuma. I stream every single day from 4 p.m. to 8 p.m. Eastern Time. If you learned anything, hit that like button and subscribe for content in the future. Alright, y'all have a good one. Good luck with the climb. Peace.